you don't know what the Toon Me Challenge is, it is a challenge that has been going around Instagram. I don't know if it's going around other social media because Instagram is essentially the only one that I use. I rarely use Twitter, even though I have one, but we're getting off topic already and the video just started. So this challenge, Toon Me, has been going around Instagram. It's basically where artists take a photo of themselves and they make half the photo in drawn piece of them, and then the other half is the actual photo, just so you can see what you would look like if you drew yourself, like, versus what you look like in real life, I guess. Now, majority of the people that I've seen do this are using like some form of digital art. I do not do digital art. I am a traditional artist, and so I was trying to figure out how the heck I was going to get this to like match up and line up perfectly the way that I assume like a digital art would. So as you can see, I printed off a picture of myself, took out my light box, and I decided to just trace over half of me, and then I was gonna put this into Krita and then like match it up to the other side of me. So you'll see that a little bit later on. Now, I'm not sure if people are gonna think that that's like cheating or not. I don't know. I don't consider it cheating. I don't think it's cheating if I, for this challenge in particular, I don't think it's cheating, because I feel like if someone was doing digital art, they would essentially do the same thing, but just digitally, where they would like draw on top of their own face, or, you know, make their face one layer and make the drawing another layer in the digital program that they're using, and essentially do the same thing I'm doing, but with digital art. I figured there was no other way that I could get it to line up perfectly unless I did it this way. Although in the end, it's still not perfect. Like, you're gonna see me like trying to fiddle with it and make it line up exactly, but for some reason it still doesn't line up exactly with it, even though I traced over my face, it still doesn't line up exactly with it. But I wanted to be a part of this challenge, and so that is why I used the light box, because I thought if I was gonna do it any other way, it just wouldn't look right, and then it wouldn't really be what the challenge is. Now, for this one, I was a little bit like unsure how I was gonna do this, because number one, I did a picture where I'm like pretty far away from like the camera, I guess, or the front of the lens, and usually my portraits are very close up. Yes, this is still, I guess, considered a portrait. I don't know if it's considered a portrait, it's kind of far back, but usually I don't draw backgrounds or anything like that, and so I was gonna have to like do all this extra stuff that I don't ever do. But if I didn't put it in the picture, I think it would have looked very unfinished. So I decided I was gonna put the background in, and what made me nervous about putting the background in is the mirror, especially. So the mirror like comes off my shoulder and like goes into my head. If you can see that line right there, that's the mirror. It looks better after I'm done because I darken it a little bit, but I was afraid that it would basically look like an extension of my bra strap, and I thought that it would make it look super weird. So I wasn't sure if I was gonna keep it in there, and then I did, and I was like, crap, what if this looks crazy? But then I could always erase it digitally, I guess. But I was trying to do most of it traditional, like on this side, because I wanted to see exactly what this challenge would look like in traditional medium, because I've seen very few traditional artists do this challenge. It's usually the digital artists that are doing it, and they turn out really, really good. But I really wanted to do one just so that I can show that traditional artists can do it too, and that's why I did it. I also was a little bit unsure of what I wanted to do with the hair, because my hair is pink. In case you didn't know, that is my icon. Is not just an icon, it is supposed to be like a very stylized version of myself. So yeah, my icon doesn't have pink hair, just because my icon has pink hair, because I have pink hair, in case you've never seen me before. Yeah, I forgot to say that in the beginning. In case you've never seen me before, that is what I look like. That is my face. My hair is a lot shorter than that now, because I did cut it off recently, like maybe like a month ago. I cut it really, really short. It's still pink, but it's like a darker pink. It's like hot pink now, and it's shorter than that. Anyways, getting back on topic. Oh, but if you do, no, anyways, getting back on topic. I'm all over the place. I'm trying to hurry up and record this before I have to leave, because I'm going to the city later on today, and I'll be going all weekend, so I'm trying to get this out. Anyways, that's besides the point. I wasn't sure what I was going to do with my hair. I wasn't sure if I should make it black, because my drawings are usually black with hair. My hair is usually black in drawings. Or if I wanted to make it pink, because I wanted to try to match it up with the color. But then I was thinking, there's no way I'm going to get the color to match exactly, and it's going to look crazy, and it's going to look like off. So I decided to do it black anyways. Although now that I'm thinking about it, I think it would have kind of been cute if I had tried to match it. Because even if it wasn't the correct color pink, it still would have been like, you know, this is what it would look like if I drew myself myself exactly, which is why I am planning on doing another Toon Me challenge. I want to do one where my eyes are open, because I did kind of cop out doing this one with my closed eyes. And then I wanted to do one where it's a little bit closer up to me, because all the ones I've seen, they've been pretty close, like really close up portraits, usually like a selfie or something. I just couldn't find one that I really liked, because even on my regular Instagram, and not my art Instagram, my regular one, I don't really post like selfies, I guess. Or I usually like set my timer and then take a picture of myself. I'm not really into selfies, I guess. I mean, I guess it's still a selfie because I am taking the picture of myself and no one else was in the house with me. But yeah, I'm not really into like the aesthetics of a selfie, of what it looks like on my face personally. I don't think selfies work for my facial structure. I'm already not very photogenic, so you know, I gotta step a little further away from the camera. But I am going to try and like get a good one so that I can do this challenge like the proper way, I guess, only because I really like the way the other ones look when they're super close up and you can like see their eyes and all that, you know. And because part of the signature of my style is like giving black eyes to the people that I draw, I would really like to do one with my eyes open so that I can do that in one of the drawings. But this is the one I'm doing for now. This is the one I posted on my Insta yesterday, so this is what it is. People seem to like it, so I guess I didn't do that bad on it. I think it turned out pretty okay, if I'm being honest. I think I really like this one, but I am still planning on doing another one, definitely. Another thing I had a little bit of a hard time with was deciding where to put the shadows. This picture is very bright, and I was like right in front of my patio door, so there's not a lot of shadows in it. And I like to add shadows to my drawings, and if I added more shadows to one side than what's on the other side, I thought it would look like not balanced correctly. So I wasn't exactly sure where to put the shadows. So this one's very light on the shadows. I think it's lighter than I usually go on the shadows, just because I couldn't like make up my own thing, because it had to match the other side, and if it didn't match it would be out here looking crazy. But I do think in the end that it turned out pretty good. One thing I do wish though is I wish I had drawn the other side of the paper, like when I split it down the middle of my face. I wish I had done the side that had more stuff on it. I just feel like I did like the smaller side, and I feel like I should have did the bigger side. I would have been able to do like the crisscross on the bralette. I would have been able to do my actual necklace. I would have been able to do like more stuff on that side, because I did very little on this side. I think I ended up doing more furniture than I really wanted to do on this side. But if I would have did the other side, then I would have to do the wall that was in back of me, and the wall has like pictures, so I wasn't sure if I wanted to do that. But this is what they look like side by side. I think it looks pretty close to what I look like, so I'm just gonna throw this over into Krita and attempt to get it to line up properly. I had such a hard time trying to get it to line up. I don't know why. It just, no matter what I did, nothing was like matching. Like I'd get the arm to match and then the hair would be off, and then I'd get the glasses to match and then the lips would be off. And I'm like, how is this possible? Like I literally lined it up exactly with the picture. How come I can't get it to fit? I think what happened was though, at one point I stretched the picture down a little bit and it just kind of like threw the whole proportion out, and I couldn't quite get the proportions back where they were before I did that. But I also just might have like overdrawn it when I did it. Like I might have just drawn a little bit more, like made the lines thicker than I should have, so it made it not line up exactly where it should have been. But I fiddle with it for a while before I finally find like a good place to get it. And then I forgot to put the freaking line down the middle, so I had to go back, put the line down the middle, because it looked like weird without the line. Like it needs some point of separation, I feel like, to show like this is where the middle of the drawing is. Even though you can clearly see where the middle of the drawing is, I think it looks better with the line, because it like breaks up the two together, so it doesn't look as crazy if they're right next to each other. So this is essentially what it looks like when it's done. I am happy with it, but like I said, I am still gonna do another one. And I do kind of wish I had put the pink in there, even though the rest of it is black and white. I think the pink would have been cute on the hair. Okay, that's all I have to say. I will see you next week. I gotta go pack. Bye.